Good afternoon, participants. I am Professor Manoj Gupta, working as a principal scientist in State Project Implementing Unit of Prakritik, Kheti, Khushhal, Kisan Yojana. I am sharing with you a certification methodology that has been developed by us exclusively for the certification of natural farming produce in the state. This methodology has been termed as a certified evaluation tool for agriculture resource analysis, natural farming, and in abbreviated form, it can be called as CETARA-NF. Since the implementation of scheme on natural farming in 2018, many farmers have started practicing natural farming on their fields. Their number has reached 1.7 lakh, that is equivalent to 0.17 million, and their this farm scheme has reached every corner of the state, and this has happened despite the restrictions imposed by the COVID. But COVID also proved as a boon for natural farming, because now the farmers and the consumer are both are aware about the ill effects of the chemical inputs on their health and on the ecology of the area. So we are hoping that there will be a huge demand for natural farming produce in the future. To meet that end, we have already taken some of the initiative for marketing of the natural farming produce. That is the creation of FPOs, captive outlets for the urban consumers, and direct retailing of the produce through canopies. We have also working on development of logos and branding material for natural produce in the state. And above all of this, we have developed an innovative self-assessed certification methodology for natural farming. And this methodology has been designated as CETARA in our state. Why this methodology was needed? We have two types of certification procedures available in our country. One is third-party certification, and one is participatory grantee system. These systems were followed for the certification of organic produce, but these, as you can see, that these systems were expensive. Particularly, the third-party certification was quite expensive and was beyond the reach of most of the farmers of the state, because more than 90% of the farmers in the state have less than 2 hectares of land holding, and they are small and marginal. Besides this, this system required extensive planning and documentation. Certification process was complex, and the cost and complexity was threshold was very high and was beyond the reach of farmers, and it also had impact on the cost of the produce for the farmers. And on the other hand, PGS, this system was applicable to the groups of the farmer. Individual farmer was not eligible to apply for this system. There was support of some of the organizations that was required for running the system, that is like regional councils and the implementation agencies. These agencies keep on working as long as the government support in the form of fund is available to them. Once the support is withdrawn, the certification system is not available to the farmer, and farmers are left high and dry in this system. And this system was available to the online, but the operation was and procedure was quite complex. So in my opinion, the complexity and bottlenecks imposed by the organic certification system were also responsible for non-popularization of the organic farming in our state. Keeping in mind all these bottlenecks of the organic certification system, we felt the need to develop a certification methodology that can overcome all the bottlenecks of the existing certification systems. Main highlights of the system was that in this case, farmer will self-certify himself. This system will be bilingual, available both in Hindi as well as in English. The farmer, who is entering the system will also be entitled in the certification system. Anyhow, he will be given only 1-star rating on joining. Since the system is being launched in the online mode, the response is very fast and within a set time frame of a week. The certification will be perpetual for the farmers until it is challenged or challenged by either by the consumer or the peer farmers or the state officials. Since all the information of this process as well as the information of the farmer is available in the public domain, we hope that the social audit will provide the checks and balance to any misuse of this system, to check the any misuse of the system. The key principle of this system is that it is very simple for even for the farmers as well as for the implementation agencies. And it is based on the principle of non-use of agrochemicals, externally sourced organic inputs, and GMOs, etc. The scoring of the system is based on the principles of natural farming as propounded under the PK3Y scheme. A farmer who is adopting complete package of the natural farming will get higher scoring under this system. This was incorporated to popularize the complete package of the natural farming, because if farmer is not adopting complete package of natural farming, there are the chances of drop in productivity of the crop as well as higher incidence of the insect and diseases. To encourage that, we have included all the components of the natural farming for arriving at the final score of the final score of the certification system. This system is scalable with other schemes also, and if the need is felt to integrate this system with the other certification regulation available at the national and international level, it can be easily scalable with them. And it is based on the principle of transparency and traceability. Transparency will ensure the complete information about the marketing channel to the farmer, whereas on the other hand, traceability will provide the information of the produce to the information about the origin of the produce to the consumer. Objective of this certification methodology is this methodology will categorize the farmers into three categories. First category will be called as the 3-star category or visist 3-star farmer. It will be a farmer who is fully practicing as per the production technology of PK3Y or the natural farming practices. Second category will be the 2-star category. It will be designated as a Sadharan 2-star farmer. A farmer who is practicing the natural farming without agrochemicals, but is dependent on some of the ex situ organic inputs. And Antral 1-star farmer will be the one who has just entered the system and presently is in the conversion to the natural farming. Certification evaluation process is quite simple in this case. Since the system will be online, farmer will fill his information through the portal of the certification system or through the mobile app. He will provide information about the various practices of natural farming he is practicing on his farm. Then he will give name and contact details of three of the farmers that will act as a peer review for him. They will provide the witness that a farmer is actually doing the natural farming and all the practices he has claimed he's actually practicing those technologies or those practices on his farm. Then this will be screened by the information will be screened by the block level officials like ATM or BTM. And upon the validation by ATM and BTM, the certification will be generated for the individual farmer, and information will be provided to him in the form of a SMS. Before validating the information, ATM and BTM, that is the block level officials, can conduct inspection schedule of the farmer, and they can also inquire from the peer farmers of the as mentioned in the registration process. Once this evaluation process is complete, farmer will get the SMS and link for downloading the certificate. Real-time monitoring of the all process will be carried out by the district level officers and the state level officers, since the system is online and all the information to the district and state level officers will be available to them on their dashboards. This is the information about himself farmer has to provide, is to give detail about himself, his address, his Aadhaar number, ID. Aadhaar is a unique ID in case of India, and he will also upload his photo. And this information will also be used for generating the I-card for the natural farming farmers. Then, as you can see, there are various practices that are advocated under natural farming. More practices he is adopting on his farm, he will get more scores. He has to give information about the various crops he is growing and how much is the expected output and how much marketable surplus will be available at the end of the season. This information about the marketable surplus will be shared with the FPOs that we are developing for the marketing of the natural produce in the state, so that availability of this information in advance will help those FPOs to plan for the marketing of the produce that is expected to be available with them at the end of the season. Likewise, various concoctions that are being used in the natural farming, more the practices he is doing, more score he will get for that. He will also get score for having a separate storage facility for SPNF produce and the inputs. Then come the activities that are restricted or prohibited in this certification system. The fields that you see in the blue color, these are the some of the market source organic inputs. These are prohibited in this system. And if any farmer is using them by purchasing this input from the market, then it will attract a penalty of -2 marks for each input. Since the main objective of natural farming is to reduce the cost of cultivation of the farmer, this is being done to discourage the farmer to use any organic input from the market. Similarly, the fields marked in the red color, these are strictly prohibited in this natural farming system, and any farmer who is applying these inputs will attract a penalty of -5 marks, and any yes entry of these four inputs will lead to non-ability of sec 3 and 2 star rating to the farmer. Farmer, that means the farmer, if he is using any chemical input, he will not be eligible for the 2 star and 3 star rating under this system. A farmer who is practicing all the inputs, all the practices of natural farming, he can score maximum 61 marks under this system. Then farmer will provide details of the peer farmers with their contact number. Then he will certify, he will make a declaration that all the information provided by him are correct. Then this system, this information, as I have told you earlier, this system information will be validated by the block level and district level officers. And after their validation and verification, a certificate will be generated for the farmer, which he can download online. The system of ranking is like this. Any farmer who is scoring more than 50 marks and not using any prohibited or restricted inputs like market purchase organic inputs or chemical inputs, he will be eligible for the 3-star rating. And farmer scoring between 30 to 50 marks will be eligible for the 2-star rating. And farmer scoring less than 30 marks and who is using any of the chemical input, he will be eligible for the 1-star rating in this system. This is the screenshot of the desktop version or the portal of the certification system that we have launched, the beta version of which has been launched, and the website address is spnfhp.in. This certificate will be generated through this system. It will have a QR code. This QR code can be scanned by the consumer for the traceability of the produce. This certificate will also give information about the area and various type of crops he is growing under on his farm under through the natural farming practices. Then there is auditing process also to check the misuse of the system. This the farmers who have scored 3-star rating, the system will identify a random sample of about 5% farmers, and these farmers will be inspected by an auditing committee comprised of the district level officers and some of the progressive farmers. All the information about the farmers will be provided to the auditing committee, and the auditing committee can draw sample of soils, leaf sample and fruit sample for arriving at the final conclusion. Similarly, out of the samples drawn by the district level committee, 2 to 5% of them will also be audited by the SPIU or the state level unit independently. If any farmer is found giving wrong information or found using the prohibited inputs, then he will be degraded from 3 or 2-star rating to the 1-star rating and will be eligible for accreditation only after 1 year. All the results of the auditing process and all the information about the star rating of the farmers will be available in the public domain, and any person, either consumer or paid farmer, can raise complaint if he has some valid information about the malpractices being adopted by the farmer. That's all. Thank you very much.